yards away. I mean, he's close to 50, 75 yards away. Throwing two trees, very large trees. A friend of mine has sent me. It's another video that I had called At Night with Denamo. That guy was really, really scared. Matter of fact, he won't play with me at night anymore. Took a lot of different achievements. Play with me in the daytime. But at night, I mean, he hasn't said it, but there's always a reason why he needs to come. So, that's what he wants to do, and he's not comfortable, but it's probably not a good idea to bring him out anyway. You got to be comfortable to be out there and to hear them. And being by myself, at least when I'm by myself, I know my life, my whole life is going to depend on myself. So I know how I'm going to react. And, you know, about 50 hours in, it's getting dark, and all of a sudden I hear a hop. Very like something very big near me, but just behind the trees, maybe 20, 30 feet away, I'm not going to panic. I might be a bit concerned, but I'm not going to panic. The thing is that they've never harmed me, they've never tried to hurt me. I'm being left better than being left a lot of different things in a lot of different areas, and everything else that I've gathered, I can associate these same individuals by casts with. Casts you can derive so much information from a cast. You can derive the information of what I like to call compression characteristics. I think the main term is called compression of these. What I call compression characteristics because this is how individuals compressing the soil underneath them. If they turn, then you're going to catch that. The characteristic of the churn in their step within the track itself, as well as the track itself. When I read a trackway, I look at one footprint as a frame in a film. When I look at the complete trackway, I look at it as a clip of film. So when I'm looking at it, I'm imagining that individual walking, creating that track. And based on what I'm interpreting in the trackway, I'm understanding what is going on in their minds. And that's how I actually looked at that other area and found all that other information and those bright white lights, or bright white eyes. Very, very, very strangely. Nothing like this. This is something completely different. But this looks like the same color in the video that I have in the last one. Where you can see there's a group of something on this ledge way up where this rock slide is created. So, if where that rock slide is, again, I have tracks. Actually, I'm submitting a way for these tracks to drive them. And a little background on that, I was waiting for them to drive. I always carry my fly rod with me when I'm up in these areas. And I'm fly fishing and playing around, and I'm waiting for these to cure so I can pull them out about 4 ounces in, about 10,000 feet up. And I decided I'm just going to take a little nap. So just about the time I'm falling asleep in this boulder, I normally sleep on boulders, sound resonators, so I can pick up anything that's going on around me. But these guys were quiet enough that didn't hear anything, didn't hear them approaching at all. What I did hear was like two little mischievous kids like whispering on both sides of me. And that's what kind of, I was just falling asleep at that time. And that's when I woke up and I decided to go ahead and put some tree roots out and created this little ritual that I did. And about 15 minutes later, I had this huge rock slide ensue. So I go back to that center again, maybe 2 days later, treat the same scenario, treat everything again, and another rock slide ensues. I go back a year later, do the same type of scenario, two sites, go hot slide this time, but as I'm heading out on this little animal trail that I go down, I find a chipmunk. And the chipmunk has been squeezed to the point that it's there, so the nasal membranes out of its nose. It was left on the trail. It was fresh. And so that was the first actual, I would determine it as a Twitter type that much for me. Since then, I've had three different snakes, three different areas. All fresh, all very, very fresh bites. They were just recently killed. So, and you'll see most of those on my YouTube site. I think they're called, let's call it endless snake, let's call it snake, because it's no. But all just straight encounter, just there. I actually brought it with me when I was in Oregon to show them others. And whenever tore that snake's head off, use a lot of force, if it was blunt force trauma. I deal with a lot of trauma in the operating room, and that's one of the things I specialize in, so I can pick it out pretty good. So and I've been doing this for about 20 years now, working in the operating room. So I've seen a lot of trauma. So this is what I'm looking at. It looks to be something traumatic and just, you know, for whatever reason, and left it on the trail, I would just walk down. And there are tracks there, tracks that match it. So I find it all very, very intriguing.
One more question for you here before we just wrap it up. And that is, where do you see your research going in the, you know, the future? How do you, how do you see it going, and what kinds of things are you interested in?
I see this continuing with the tracks and stuff. I think it's just a matter of giving them the time of wanting to expose themselves to get closer to me, not me go after them, but them come after me. So that, again, we're working on their turn. So whenever they decide that it's going to happen, it's going to happen. I'm not going to rush it. I'm going to continue what I do, continue to gather more tracks. I'm also going to look at, as I gather the tracks, I'm also going to look at whether these tracks are still growing. If they're still growing, then that tells me that when I started this, that this person wasn't 13, 14 years old, but is now any younger. So now you got to add somebody, you know, walking around at 13, 14 years old right now, that are walking in this area of America by themselves, or with a group of people that are also walking around America. I've never met any hippies up in Sierra walking around America with hundreds of paper stuff. Always looking for an answer to what I'm thinking. I'm very skeptical of what I'm reflecting. When I look at stuff, when I video stuff, I video stuff through the eyes of a skeptic. So I'm looking at, just at the beginning, I wanted to find information. I wanted to see something. Then that's what I'm going to film. So that if it comes up, I already have a bank of this information. Or track, or casts, or any other things that I can gather. So that's how I gear my research. Eventually, I want to continue doing this. Eventually, what I would love to do is start my own survival school in Sierra. I don't take food up with me in the wilderness. I take very, I maintain complete, but about 30 times I just move up on land. I want to teach people how to do this. To being truly
thank you.